year ago, an Olympic athlete was killed at the Vancouver Games, and now new reports are coming out today. Now that we've counted out Tiger Woods, two of golf's best players say, don't count out Tiger Woods. And A-Rod becomes Orville Redenbacher. This is Three Point Stance. I'm Reed Cherner. I am joined by USA Today columnist Christine Brennan, who knows all things Olympics. And let's just start out on the somber note. A year ago, we had the Georgian loser who was killed. And a little bit of blame went to him. Now we're getting new reports. Give it to him.
Exactly, Reed. It is hard to believe it's already been a year since that tragedy of the day of the opening ceremonies when Nodar Komaritashvili, the Georgian loser, was killed in a training run. You may remember at the time the IOC people and others officials said they started to blame him, that he was not a strong enough loser, that it was his fault. Well, now an email has come out dated from March of 2009, Reed, almost a year before the accident, saying that the track, many thought the track was too fast, and the words were that someone could get badly hurt. That was 11 months before the accident. And it's just reprehensible to think that these officials, these Olympic officials and luge officials, started to blame an athlete who was dead. And once again, tells us that something we've known for years, which is that the last amateurs left in the Olympic world are the people running the sports. A sad story, of course.
Of course. Let's go to something not so sad. And that's while all of us are believing that Tiger may have to go back to Q school to get his PGA Tour card, Martin Kaymer and Lee Westwood are saying watch out for Tiger this week. Now, people have been saying that, you know, since he's had his problems, but are we watching out for Tiger this week, I should say?
I think we always are watching out for Tiger and whenever he plays. But I was intrigued by this, you know, that you've got two of the top players, Martin Kaymer and Lee Westwood, saying don't count out Tiger Woods. And I think we're going to see that headline and that storyline till the day Tiger retires. I'm not saying that it's not legitimate, but it almost makes you smile because we're so used to this man, the greatest golfer maybe ever, certainly one of the top two or three ever, playing. We're so used to Tiger playing great, Reed, of course. And when he doesn't play great, I think we're conditioned. It's almost in our DNA to say, well, he's going to play great next week. He's going to be good next week. He's going to come back. And I just find it fascinating because so far he's playing worse, not better. But no one should be surprised when these guys say Tiger's going to be good and don't count him out. They need him to play well for, obviously, TV ratings and their money, their pocketbooks. And also, I think that they're just waiting like we are for the time when Tiger finally, you know, puts it together.
Now, the last thing is the Super Bowl proved why you and I have a clause in our contract, no snacks on the set. A-Rod is shown being fed popcorn by Cameron Diaz. Now, while most people might be a little envious of both Cameron Diaz and A-Rod for being together as a couple, A-Rod was irate that Fox showed him. That's just our funny of the day.
Well, you know, as you said, you know, here's this guy. He's as popular and as well-known as any athlete on the planet. A-Rod's certainly one of them. And he's angry. Reports are that he is upset. He was irate, furious with Fox for showing him. Now, how ridiculous is this? I mean, first of all, again, he's such a popular person. Obviously, he's dating an actress. She's very popular. But the reality is that when you're in a public place, when you're at the Super Bowl and you're in a suite, you're in a box that includes the former President of the United States and others, to think that you're not going to be shown, you're not going to be photographed, that your picture won't be taken, what is A-Rod thinking? And how silly, how ridiculous is he looking, Reed? You and I both laughed about it. And again, A-Rod, you're a public figure. You're in a public place. It's the Super Bowl. If you don't want your picture to be taken, don't go or hide somewhere in the end zone or put on one of those masks to be somebody else, because otherwise you are fair game. And, of course, this is the way of the world, especially on Super Bowl Sunday.
That's 3 minutes with Christine Brennan, where there is no spoon-fed news. But please join us again tomorrow, and please pick up tomorrow's USA Today, where Christine's column will appear. I'm Reed Cherner, and we'll see you again.